This is KSL, your news specialists at 10.
Mike, some new information on that explosion.
Yeah, we certainly do. We now know what caused a natural gas compressor station in Carbon County to explode on Tuesday. This is some of the dramatic video that we shot over the course of the last several days. Investigators say that a damaged pipeline is to blame and that two men injured in the blast are just lucky to be alive. Eastern Utah news specialist Jeff Lysak spoke exclusively with the lead investigator tonight and has the details.
The deputy state fire marshal I talked to tonight here in Carbon County told me that this explosion would have been absolutely massive. He said the fact that anybody survived at all is a miracle.
If they'd been in any other area of that compound, it'd probably killed him.
62-year-old Larry Joseph and 31-year-old Doug Jenkins may still be hospitalized, but things could have been much worse, according to Deputy State Fire Marshal Troy Mills.
They went and shut the equipment down and then started to try and evacuate when the explosion occurred. They were behind one of the buildings, and the building protected them.
Mills was part of a team of investigators that spent the day sifting through the damaged compressor station owned by Denver-based Bill Barrett Corporation before zeroing in on the cause of the explosion.
A 12-inch high-pressure gas line had been damaged at some point by a backhoe. You could see score marks along the top of the pipe where the backhoe teeth had rubbed on the top of the pipe and scored the pipe. The pressure surged in the pipe, and that was the weak link. The pipe failed and it basically tore open. Looked like an aluminum can.
The ruptured pipe shot a stream of pressurized natural gas into the compressor station, where it found an ignition source that touched off the explosion. Mills said nothing in his investigation indicated that there was any criminal wrongdoing or negligence.
I think it's just an accident.
Bill Barrett owns two other compressor stations here in Nine Mile Canyon. We've been told that one of those is still shut down because of yesterday's explosion. As for when the company thinks it'll be able to reopen the damaged compressor station, they simply don't know. Back to you.